Hello students, in our last topic we discussed about male reproductive system along with structure of testis, where it located, what are the layers present around side of the testis. And today we will discuss about TS of testis. In TS of testis, generally three type of cells we can observe. When we observe the TS of testis, we can observe three types of cells. First one, germ cells. Second one, Sertoli cells. Third one, Leydig cells. These three types of cells we can observe in the case of TS of testis. That means, testis is a oval shaped structure. And if we cut the testis in a transverse section mode, then we can observe these kind of appearance. In the testis, we already discussed that testis divides into nearly 250 compartments by the help of tunica albuginea. Tunica albuginea, when it penetrates into testis, then what will happen? It divides into different type of compartments. Nearly 250 compartments will be formed because of the protruding tunica albuginea. For example, if it is testis, and here tunica albuginea is entering into testis. Now what is happening here? This one compartment, this one compartment, this one compartment. Likewise, what is happening here? Testis is dividing into different compartments. So that what is happening? Tunica albuginea is penetrating into testis, so the 250 compartments will be present. And in each compartment we can observe 1 to 3 seminiferous tubules. Each compartment, it consists how many seminiferous tubules? 1 to 3 seminiferous tubules. That means, for example, in a testis exactly 250 compartments is present, and each compartment it consists 3 seminiferous tubules, then each testis consists how many seminiferous tubules? 750 seminiferous tubules. Anyway, each compartment consists 1 to 3 seminiferous tubules, and that seminiferous tubules will appear like vesicle-like structures present in the testicular compartments. Observe here. So, seminiferous tubule is actually made by two types of cells. That means, germ cells and Sertoli cells are present in each seminiferous tubule. Seminiferous tubule consists two types of cells, and Leydig cells are present outside of the seminiferous tubule. And here, when you observe the testis, TS of testis, there are seminiferous tubules are present, and there is some empty space also present. Observe here. There is some empty space also present. That empty space is also called interstitial space. That empty space is also called interstitial space. It is filled with interstitial fluid. And in that interstitial fluid, there is irregular shaped cells are present. Irregular shaped cells present in interstitial space. Interstitial space, nothing but space present within the ossuary, between the seminiferous tubules. So, between the seminiferous tubules, there is some space. That space is nothing but interstitial space. And that interstitial space consists some randomly arranged irregular shaped cells. There is no particular pattern, randomly arranged. At the same time, they are irregular shaped cells. That cells are also called Leydig cells. Likewise, there is three type of cells we can observe in the case of TS of testis. Then, what is the function of these three type of cells? Here, germ cells helpful to produce sperm cells by the process spermatogenesis. Germ cells helpful to produce sperm cells, and that process is also called spermatogenesis. We will discuss about spermatogenesis as the next topic. And coming to Sertoli cells. Sertoli cells helpful to produce three type of material, three type of hormones. One is anti-Mullerian hormone. anti-Müllerian hormone, and second hormone is androgen binding protein. Androgen binding protein, and third one inhibin. Likewise, three type of substances will be produced by Vissels Sertoli cells. So Sertoli cells produces these substances: anti-Müllerian hormone, androgen binding protein, and inhibin. And next, coming to leading cells. Leading cells helpful to produce a kind of hormone which is also called testosterone. Testosterone. So testosterone hormone is secreting by leading cells. Inhibin is secreting by Sertoli cells. Anti-Müllerian hormone is secreting by Sertoli cells. Along with that, they are also producing androgen binding protein. Here, what are the functions of this? As we already know that sperm cells act as male gamete. And in this case, sperm cell act as male gamete means they are carrying genetic material, father's genetic material into the next baby through male gamete. And in this case, anti-Müllerian hormone. Here we have to discuss about two type of ducts. One is Wolffian duct. And Müllerian duct. Actually, ducts present in male reproductive system. Ducts present in male reproductive system mainly formed from Wolffian duct. Ducts present in female reproductive system formed from Müllerian duct. That means fallopian tube or oviduct. It is formed from Müllerian duct. So, oviduct or fallopian tube are important for female reproductive system, and that are not necessary for male reproductive system. That's why in the male reproductive system, there is a certain type of cells, Sertoli cells. They secrete a kind of anti-Müllerian hormone which suppress the growth of or formation of Müllerian duct. So that if Müllerian duct is not formed, then ducts related to female reproductive system or female reproductive system growth will be suppressed by the help of anti-Müllerian hormone. So that female reproductive characters will not develop in the case of males. That is the importance of anti-Müllerian hormone. And then coming to androgen binding protein or ABP. It helps to concentration of testosterone. Androgen binding protein helpful to concentration of testosterone. Here, testosterone is actually secreting from leading cells. And that testosterone concentration will be increased by the help of androgen binding protein. Then, what is the need to increase the testosterone concentration? When the testosterone concentration is increasing, then that increased concentration of testosterone actually act on germ cells. So then what will happen? Germ cells will start producing sperm cells. That means androgen binding protein increases the concentration of testosterone. That increased concentrated testosterone stimulates the germ cells. That germ cells then what will happen? Produces sperm cells. Likewise, androgen binding protein indirectly stimulates the germ cells to produce sperm cells. At the same time, they also produce inhibin. Before going to discuss about inhibin, first we need to discuss about the other gonadotropin releasing hormone or follicular stimulating hormone or LH. We already know that gonadotropin releasing hormone, I'm erasing this one. Gonadotropin releasing hormone, which is also said to be GnRH, it is secreting from hypothalamus. So hypothalamus is secreting which hormone? Gonadotropin releasing hormone. These gonadotropin releasing hormone act on pituitary. So gonadotropin release hormone acting on pituitary gland. So they produce two type of hormones. One is follicular stimulating hormone. Second one, luteinizing hormone. Hypothalamus is producing gonadotropin releasing hormone. That gonadotropin releasing hormone is acting on pituitary gland. So pituitary gland is releasing follicular stimulating hormone. Follicular stimulating hormone along with it, they also produce luteinizing hormone. Here, what is the function of follicular stimulating hormone? In this case, follicular stimulating hormone then act on Sertoli cells. Follicular stimulating hormone act on Sertoli cells. So Sertoli cells will produce these three type of hormones. At the same time, they also produces luteinizing hormone. These luteinizing hormone then act on leading cells. Luteinizing hormone is acting on leading cells. So that leading cells will produce testosterone. Now observe here. First, what is happening? Hypothalamus is producing gonadotropin releasing hormone. This gonadotropin releasing hormone is stimulating this pituitary. Pituitary is releasing which hormone? Follicular stimulating hormone. This follicular stimulating hormone, they are acting on Sertoli cells. Sertoli cells are releasing anti-Müllerian hormone, androgen binding protein, inhibin hormone. And in this case, what is happening? This androgen binding protein is stimulating the concentration of testosterone which is secreting by leading cells. But leading cells will get stimulated to synthesize testosterone because of which hormone? Luteinizing hormone. So, first, gonadotropin releasing hormone is stimulating pituitary gland so that they are producing follicular stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. Because of these two hormones, what is happening? All these hormones are producing. Okay, but what is the function of inhibin? That is the question now. When the luteinizing hormone is acting on leading cells, they are producing testosterone. Concentration of testosterone is increasing by androgen binding protein, and then they are acting on germ cells, so that what is happening? Sperm cells production takes place. Okay, that is the way generally goes on. If more number of sperm cells are producing, if more number of germ cells producing, then to stop the spermatogenesis, inhibin again will act on pituitary. Inhibin will act on pituitary. So that what will happen? It stop secretion of follicular stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone. That means follicular stimulating hormone and luteinizing hormone are stimulating Sertoli cells and leading cells to synthesize testosterone and sperm cells. At the same time, inhibin stops the production of these testosterone hormone as well as formation of sperm cells. When the sperm cells are produced more, then inhibin starts their function. They directly act on pituitary and stop the production of these two hormones. So then what will happen? These two functions will be stopped. So to control these spermatogenesis, to control the production of testosterone, to control the formation of more number of sperm cells, which hormone will be helpful? Inhibin. Likewise, different type of cells are present. And here, we need to discuss about Sertoli cells. In this case, Sertoli cells also helpful for nutrition. Sertoli cells also helpful for nutrition. These Sertoli cells supply nutrients to the sperm cells. So, for nutrition purpose also, these Sertoli cells are helpful. At the same time, they also act as a checkpoint for the completely formed sperm cells. Sertoli cells helpful for nutrition, and they also act as checkpoint. And coming to next one, here they organize phagocytosis. So here, observe it. When you observe this seminiferous tubule, there is epithelial tissue, stratified epithelial tissue. That epithelial tissue will get stimulated by the help of, that means leading cells will produce testosterone. They act on this germ cells, so that germ cells will produce sperm cells. And in this case, when the germ cells are releasing sperm cells, these Sertoli cells means elongated columnar cells, these cells will absorb the sperm cells which are releasing into seminiferous tubule. All the sperm cells which are forming from the germ cells are releasing into seminiferous tubule. When they are releasing from the germ cells to outside, at that point these Sertoli cells will observe, will check that whether the sperm cell morphology is completely formed, whether all parts are formed in that sperm cell completely or not. If sperm cell completely formed, that sperm cells will be released into lumen of seminiferous tubule. If the sperm cells are not formed properly, immediately what they organize? Phagocytosis. That means they feed the incompletely formed or abnormal sperm cells will get phagocytosis by which cells? Sertoli cells. And remaining completely formed sperm cells will release us into lumen of this seminiferous tubule. At the same time, the completely formed healthy sperm cells also will get nutrients from the Sertoli cells. Likewise, different type of cells present in there. Here, three type of cells we can observe majorly. One is germ cells, Sertoli cells and leading cells. Germ cells helpful to produce sperm cells by the process known as spermatogenesis. And for the purpose to conduct the spermatogenesis, they need the stimulation of testosterone. This testosterone is secreted by leading cells. And to synthesize the testosterone by leading cells, they need the stimulation of which hormone? Luteinizing hormone. And luteinizing hormone is actually releasing from pituitary gland by the stimulation of which hormone? Gonadotropin releasing hormone. And here, testosterone which is releasing from the leading cells not directly stimulates the germ cells. Increased concentration of testosterone stimulates the germ cells. So here, leading cells are synthesizing testosterone. To stimulate the or to concentrate the testosterone, they need androgen binding protein, that is secreting from Sertoli cells. Along with that, these Sertoli cells also synthesize anti-Mullerian hormone and inhibin. And to release these three hormones, these Sertoli cells needs the stimulation of follicular stimulating hormone. It is also secreting from pituitary gland by the stimulation of gonadotropin releasing hormone. And here, when you observe these TSR testes, we can observe three types of cells and they are helpful to produce germ cells. At the same time, they are also helpful to produce different type of hormones. In this, primary function is production of gametes. Secondary function is to act as an endocrine gland by releasing different type of hormones. That is the information related to TSR testes. And in the next video, we will discuss about sperm cell structure along with spermatogenesis.